Broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello and welcome to TSBA's Byboard webinar. I'm Randall Bennett, Deputy Executive Director and General Counsel, and we're welcoming you to our webinar today. For those of you that are interested in Byboard, and I hope that's all of you, we've got a special guest to talk to us about the program, how it works, how it can simplify your purchasing, make it easier for you to get what you need quicker. And that is going to be our National Director, Dave Ricketts. Dave, I want to turn the program over to you, but before I do, I want to point out that we do have some handouts that you can download here. On the right-hand side of your screen, you will see the Byboard presentation, what you're going to see on screen, as well as the online instructions as how to sign up for Byboard. Also, there's a place for questions. If you have questions, please type them in there, and when we finish the webinar, we will get to those questions and answer them. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Dave.
Thanks, Randy. Thank you, everybody, for showing up today, and appreciate your interest in the Purchasing Cooperative. The Purchasing Cooperative is sponsored in the state of Tennessee by the Tennessee School Board Association, and the monies that are funded go back into the public education system here in the state of Tennessee. So it's a win for the districts in trying to purchase things, as well as a win for public education across the state of Tennessee. As Randy mentioned, if you have questions, please type them in and we'll answer them at the end of the seminar. It'll take about 15, 20 minutes, maybe 25 minutes to go through the actual presentation itself. And then we'll spend 5-10 minutes reviewing the website itself, giving you a sense and a flavor of what that looks like as well. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and start the presentation. One moment. All right, we are ready to go. All right, so what exactly is Byboard and what is a purchasing cooperative? I'm going to start at the 40,000 foot view of what a purchasing cooperative is and how it is able for you guys to use it. So a purchasing cooperative is a type of cooperative arrangement that aggregates the demand to get lower prices from selected suppliers. Really, what does that mean? It just means that we're contracting with vendors to get better pricing through higher volumes. There are a couple of different types of purchasing cooperatives out in the marketplace today. There is a lead agency, which the Byboard is. It's a governmental agency and the originator of the contracting process, the owner of the life cycle of the awarded contracts. That means that we as the lead agency do everything from solicitation to the end of the expiration of that contract. There are others out in the marketplace that aren't lead agencies. They're non-governmental bodies. It's more of a market basket approach when it comes to contracting. They themselves will reach out to a lead agency and have them actually do a contract. And a lead agency is a city, a county, a school. They will lean on them to do a contract for that purchasing cooperative and then bring all of those different contracts into a basket of which the members can use. Think of somebody like a U.S. Communities. That's that kind of model. A little overview of the Byboard. The Byboard itself has been around since the 1990s. Here in Tennessee, it's a free value-added service provided by the TSBA to you as its members. It is a nonprofit that provides funding to enhance Tennessee's public education system, as I mentioned earlier. The Byboard is also a lead agency controlling, again, the procurement process and life cycle of the contracts. What does that do for you? It gains you access to a wide range of vendors with pricing based on national volume levels. It's an outreach to local and regional and MWBE vendors to participate. And I'll get into a little bit of that in a little bit. It's also EDGAR certified. A lot of the vendors are for federal fund use. The buy board itself is governed by an 8 board member of trustees. They are procurement professionals. A lot of you out in the audience may be of that. And so they are folks just like yourselves that review all the contracts and the process that every contract goes through. There are currently about 6,800 entities, members across the country, higher ed to cities to counties to public education institutions. There are membership in 40 different states. We cover about 29 different contracts, ranging from, again, pencils to buses to fire trucks and just about anything in between. How do school districts benefit? It is a free membership to join as a member of the TSBA. Again, it's a value-added service that they are bringing to you as a member of the TSBA. It's going to lower the cost typically for the products and services that you are going to need to operate your school districts. It leverages the power of again, nationwide volume pricing, so it's most often lower than you could typically get as an individual district. There is an RFP reduction from the school's perspective. It just eliminates some of them, certainly not all of them, but some of the RFPs that are going to be required to purchase the things that you all need to get. It does streamline the procurement process. Your staff doesn't have to go through the preparation, the specifications, the advertising, the reviewing the proposals, awarding the bids, and defending the awards. All of that stuff has been done by the buy board. You as a member, it reduces the procurement and administrative costs because, of course, that process has been eliminated for, again, some of the contracts. It's never going to take the place of doing all contracts. There's always going to be a necessity for you all to do your own, but hopefully this will take some of the burden away from you. It provides a vehicle to, again, serve internal customers' needs better. From the point that the need is determined to the time of delivery or satisfaction of that need, using a cooperative like the buy board just shrinks that timeline up a lot. From now you can identify the need, go into the database, identify the vendor that serves those products, and then start the procurement process right away. So what does a good contract actually look like? What's the process of that? So they must be a local government agency. They must follow strict procurement guidelines. And the cooperative should be governed by a board of directors consisting of procurement specialists that know what, again, what good looks like from a procurement perspective. Again, all contracts must go through a competitive procurement process in order to be awarded, must be in compliance with all local and state procurement requirements, and must provide a detailed documentation trail for any sort of audits that might come up. So why can my district use the buy board specifically through the TSBA? I am not going to read this, but this is a state statute. There's much more of the statute to it, but it really just comes down to being able to work together through a cooperative program like this in order to facilitate the needs at a lower cost for the districts. So what does the purchasing landscape look like today? So what are the members looking for? What are you looking for? You're certainly looking for a legal pathway to purchase that saves both time and the money, right? So through those volume discounts that we talked about. It needs to be trusted and transparent source for legally awarded contracts. Everything that you would need from a document standpoint is out on the website. I will stop and say that this is, as I mentioned, a nonprofit, meaning that we are guided by the open records law, so there's nothing that you might need that we can't give you. You're looking for quality products and certainly equipment and services from vetted companies that can perform and deliver those. And through the award process, that's exactly what happens. We multiple award under our contracts, meaning there are multiple vendors that serve more than just that one particular contract. So that gives you options. So if you like one type of product versus another, there's some choices out there for you instead of singling out just one vendor because you may or may not like that. You may have had a bad experience with that vendor and so on. Companies that are, understand why they're part of the purchasing cooperative in the first place. Not only why they support public education, but supporting you as members in the education system. The members benefit from a compliance with state procurement requirements. You all get very competitive pricing. It reduces the procurement cycle for the school district, saves administrative time and cost because, again, you can jump on and piggyback off of our contract without trying to recreate the wheel and create your own. Vendor selection is certainly wide, and the depth and breadth of our contracts is pretty extensive. So there's lots of choices. And I'll go through a request for quote feature that we have embedded into our database. So you can actually, within the framework of all these well-vetted vendors already, request a quote for what you're looking for and maybe even drive down some further cost savings with them. One moment, please. All right, we're having a little PowerPoint challenges. Okay, so there's two sides to the coin, right? So there's the member side. Y'all have identified the need and what you're looking for, but then there's the vendor side of the coin. So both need to work in concert with one another in order to get everything done for the internal customers. And at the end of the day, educate our kiddos in the classroom. The vendor benefits, why would a vendor want to become part of the buy board? For these very reasons, it streamlines and is a focus for their selling efforts. It reduces the individual bid responses. So think about them on their side of this. You guys are putting out RFPs and RFQs and so they're receiving those from multiple places all the time. So it's time consuming and expensive on their end as much as yours. So if they're part of this process, that eliminates at least some of that on their end as well. They have, and you have, the opportunity to work together directly under our contract. So they can choose to work with you. But back and forth, you can work with them and they can work with you back and forth right under our contract. And it also increases their business opportunity, right? So it's got to be a win-win for both the member and the vendor. Hope that makes sense. Here are some of the benefits of that request for quote that I had mentioned. The member benefit, it's all electronic, all online. So the RFQ looks, once you get into our database, and I'll show you that in a minute, you can upload your specifications, pick out the vendors you want to send them to, and send it off. And you can literally do it within a couple of minutes. And then those vendors get a notification. They see out there an email saying, hey, a Byboard member has something out there that they want you to provide pricing on. So they get into the database and take a look at it. So there's no advertising costs on your end either, no mailing costs. You're going to have a faster response time. And again, you're already working within the well-vetted base of vendors that are available to you. Within the system, it automatically tabulates all of their pricing. And I'll show you that, what that looks like in a second. And from a vendor's perspective, again, they're receiving it. It's all electronic. There's no cost to them. It's a faster turnaround for them. It's all confidential, and they can keep track of the pricing history. So that's really the Byboard, what purchasing co-ops are, what a co-op contract process should look like, what a contract should go through in order for y'all to leverage it, how to join the Byboard. You can go directly to our website at www.byboard.com to self-register. There is some information that you will need to fill out. There is a click the terms and conditions. It does say in there that it asks you if you have had the opportunity to take this in front of your board, which as school districts, you will need to do just to make sure that they are aware of you guys signing up for this. Once that is done, you'll get an email from a terrific young lady in our office called Gina Montoya. She will send out some information to you. They're about the RFQ, shopping, and all that kind of stuff online. Myself, as well as Tamara Seitz, helps cover Tennessee. So we are here to help you get things started, as well as the local vendors. I had mentioned the MWBE and the local vendors at the outset. One of the things that makes us a little bit different than some of the other co-ops is that we want to know who you use from a vendor perspective. We want to know who out there in the marketplace would be a good fit for us from a vendor perspective. We always are looking for those local and regional players that might be not only a good fit for you continuing on, but others that other school district, other cities, counties, that might be an opportunity for that vendor to be part of the Byboard. They still have to go through the competitive procurement process, but if they're awarded a contract, boy, if they have the right business model, not only can they continue to service you, your school district, but other school districts across the state, but also across the country. So if they have, the right business model, they can really have a life-changing event when they become part of a national purchasing cooperative. So with that, I'm going to show you a couple of just a sampling of some of the vendors that we have. American Reading for instruction materials, Techline for outdoor lighting, G&K for uniforms and that type of thing, O'Reilly Auto Parts, Best Buy, Grasshopper. Modular buildings, play and park, playgrounds, and Dectronics scoreboards. Those are just a very, very small sampling of some of the vendors that we have available to you. One of the things that will also be available for you to download shortly will be the complete list of contracts and vendors that are available, so you can take a look at that as well. So with that, I'm going to stop and see if there are any questions, and then we will take a look at the website. All right, as not seeing any, we are going to jump into our website. All right, this is what when you log in, you're going to see something similar to this. What you're going to actually see, can I manage? Okay, good. So I'm going to show you what you would see, and then I am going to jump back in here. This is what we're going to do is take a few minutes to go through an RFQ for you. So when you log into our system, this is what you will see. The TSBA and the Tennessee Recreation and Park Association, both are the state sponsors of the program in the state of Tennessee. You will see information that covers some of the more pertinent, up-to-date types of things on our website. We put that on our splash page. The website itself is pretty simplistic. It's all keyword search for things that you're looking for. Up at the top is the administrative tabs. What you're going to do is, as somebody within the school district will be appointed the administrator, and so they can create users, edit users, that kind of thing. I'll come back to this RFQ tab in a moment. Under the report tab are all the PO statuses, the current vendor list. That's also where you can find it. Group users and a login summary. Shopping cart, I'll also come back to that in a minute. Over to the left in this pink mauve-ish looking area, you can search by vendor, you can search by contract, you can search by keyword search. So I'm going to click on search by vendor. So if I know of a vendor, I can find them in here. So if I'm looking for, let's say I'm HVAC, I'm looking for air filters. Air Filter Inc. is who I want to use. I can click on search. Their information will come up. So there's a 55% discount on their air filters for their HVAC systems. All the information, as I mentioned, is all in here. All the contracts are loaded into our system. If you click on any of the vendors in that highlighted blue area, all their contact and contract information will come up. So within every vendor that the buy board has, there is a point of contact within that vendor to help answer any specific product questions, delivery questions, anything specific to that particular order. For Air Filters Inc., it happens to be Susan Janes. You can call her at this number up here, and she will be glad to help you with anything air filter related. So every vendor, again, has a point of contact. So you're not calling the 1-800 number and getting John and Susie and whoever else next to start your conversation over again. Their website information is in there. Their email information is in there. Down below is all of their freight information. And at the very bottom of this page is the vendor file documents. So that's where all their contract documentation resides. So if you need that for your own files, everything down that you might need is down there at the bottom. I'm not going to open them up, but that's the vendor proposal file is their actual contract with us. So you can look at all of the contract information right there in the database itself. So that's how you search by vendor. If you're not sure how what vendors are available to you, you can certainly search by contract. In here are all the different types of contracts that we have. If you're looking for athletic stuff for the baseball team, for instance, you can see who is in here. You can then search by category underneath here. That eliminates a lot of the things that would maybe come up for you. So you can look for athletic clothing, for instance, or athletic equipment supplies. So let's just click on equipment and supplies. That will show you who the vendors are, their discounts. You can even then go back over here and do it by category and continue to narrow the search even further and further down. So you can do it that way. You can then click on vendors to see in a nutshell who those vendors are. Maybe you pick out one or two that you know can provide them. But as you can see, there are multiple vendors under this particular contract that can supply a lot of different athletic equipment. So US Games could do some, Soccer Corner can do other things that one other might not be able to do. So there's a lot of variation in the different vendors that we have simply because of the product and services that they offer themselves. Then there's a keyword search. So if you're looking for a mower, maybe a zero turn mower, you just type in the word mower and you click on the little magnifying glass, it's going to come up with everything mower related. So if you're looking for a zero turn mower, so now I've narrowed it down for my entire database just to the mowers. Now if I'm looking for zero turn mowers, we'll see who comes up here. And now these are the zero turn mower providers. So now we've taken the whole database down to mowers, down to zero turn mower providers. And so now you can reach out to these individually and get a quote from them. So that's really how this works, the search function works. I'm going to step out of this particular one. I am going to show you the RFQ tool. I'm not going to go through an entire one simply because I would create one, and I don't want to do that. So you can create an RFQ. So if you're going to pick the commodity that you're looking for, let's just say we're looking for furniture for our school. You can pick out a few, maybe it's a Hertz or a K-Log. We'll just stick with those two. But you can pick them all just by clicking up this guy right up here. It highlights them all, or you can pick one or two that you want to work with. And again, the function at the end of the day is, this is going to send your specifications out to the vendors that you choose. The database is going to summarize that information that the vendors put into the database for you. And then you can then make a logical choice based on the pricing, the service level that you've had, maybe experience in the past, with the appropriate vendor that you want to work with. So you click on next, it pulls up your information, it knows who you are based on your login information. So this is me. I'm going to pick out a date that I want my information back from my vendors. So I'll just say a week. I can upload my specification. So if I know exactly what I'm looking for out of maybe a catalog or off a website, and I have that in a file format, I can upload it right here. It makes it a little bit easier for the vendor to see exactly what you're looking for. If I do not, I can put a description of what I might be looking for. And again, the more information you have available to that vendor, the better off he or she is going to be able to provide that information coming back to you. In the vendor notes, you can put, substitutes acceptable, no deliveries after 3, can't accept a 50-foot trailer, those kinds of things in there. You can then add edit. If we haven't uploaded our information, we need to either way put a number of in here. So if we're looking for 10 tables, if you know the unit measure, the product, the manufacturer, all that kind of stuff, that's even that much better. If I'm looking for a blue table, then I'm going to hit save item, and then it summarizes my information down here at the bottom. If I've uploaded everything that I want to send to my vendors, I can then just hit summary. And so it's going to summarize everything that I have done. In this case, we just did one blue table. I'm going to send it off to the Hertz and K-Log for pricing. And right here, I'm not going to do it, but I would send it to the vendors. And all their information would then be populated back in here. I'm going to eliminate that. I'm going to show you a live one. And I'll show you exactly what one actually does look like. So let's pick one. Lockhart ISD is looking for some football stuff. And here's all the information that they're looking for, the item numbers. Here's all the vendors that they sent them to. If I click on tabulate RFQ, you can see that they come in to the pricing and start loading the pricing in. So American Team Sports put in their stuff. They're the only one that have done that thus far. But as it gets later and later towards the date of it's supposed to be done by, all of this stuff will be done by all of those vendors. So we're going to take a quick look at one more and see if we can find one in here. As you can see, a lot of people use it a lot. Here's some from Millington. Here's some from Florida. All kinds of different stuff. Here's Germantown looking for Farmington, books for Farmington Elementary. So they uploaded all their information that they were looking for, sent it out to the vendors that they were looking for, looking from. And they sent it to quite a few, which is totally fine. And then we're going to click on tabulate the RFQ. And so, again, here's a good example of the different vendors and what they put into the system. So item number one, you can see item number two, everybody, a lot of folks have responded with pricing. And if you will notice under the pricing column, it prices it out at from the lowest to the highest based on their pricing. And so so you can then go in and award them. And this is all internal use. This is not an external one. So you can click on I awarded this, I awarded that under here, and then you can then click on award report, and it will show you exactly who you awarded them to. You can then, and that does, all that does is put it into a PDF for you, and so you can manage that with them by you know, attaching it to their PO or whatever else. You can call them or email them with that specific PDF. So that's the RFQ process. So this is all, again, all awarded vendors, but it's a terrific tool that's already embedded into a well-vetted set of vendors that you guys have access to. So it's just one more process, one more tool for you guys to leverage under the buy board. So in recapping, the buy board is, again, sponsored in the state of Tennessee by the Tennessee School Board Association as well as the TRPA. It is a free value-added service that is brought to you by the TSBA as a member of the TSBA. It is a terrific purchasing tool for you guys to leverage. It'll bring some cost savings, as we've clearly shown, and some time saving as well. And we're all trying to do, again, more with less. And so we're hoping that this is going to bring some value to you. It's never going to replace the need for the school districts to do some of their own contracting, but it's certainly going to help alleviate some of those, hopefully for you guys. So we do have a question. It says, what is the response? A reasonable amount of time to request a due date? Good question. It kind of depends on what you're looking for and the complexity of what you're looking for. The RFQ is a terrific tool if you're looking for something that is commoditized, like the school books. But if you're looking for something a little bit more complicated, then if you're looking to install an HVAC system or something along those lines, this is probably not the tool to use. It is, again, a terrific tool for commoditized type of stuff. But if you need to work with the vendors one-on-one, you're probably going to want to reach out to them on an individual basis. But for commoditized types of a product, again, it depends on the complexity of it. But a few days to a week, maybe 10 days at the most, is the length of time that is typically put out there. But it's all up to you and your individual time schedule, quite frankly. If you are in no hurry and have other things on your plate and want to deal with this in a couple of weeks, you can put that out in a couple of weeks. So good question. Are there maybe any other questions before we finish up? Okay. So you have how to sign up. The information is out there on the web. As a downloadable PDF for you, as well as this presentation as well. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Randy to sign off.
Thank you very much, Dave. And as you can see, this is quite an effective tool. If you have other people in your system that you'd like to view this webinar, it will be available on our website along with the handouts and the other things that we mentioned earlier. So please direct them to that so they can take a look at it again. And if you've got any additional questions, please contact us. Dave Ricketts is listed on our website. You can email him directly and he can answer those questions. Dave, is there anything else you want to add?
No, I just appreciate everybody's time and look forward to working with you.
All right, and thank you all very much for being a part of our lunchtime webinar, and we'll see you again in our next meeting.